In this lecture, we are going to deepen the topic of massive production scheduling, a very relevant phase in the whole production planning process between the strategic operation planning and sales and operation planning above and materials planning and production scheduling below. In this phase, as for any other planning phase, we are providing an answer to what technological families that should be produced in which weeks or months as a planning bucket over a planning horizon which may be ranging from a few months to at least 1 year depending on the business, and considering production sites, lines and cells as resources to be scheduled, and units or lots as units or production. This graphical representation is helpful to try to understand what is the level of complexity of this activity, and which is usually represented as a table of numbers and decisions to be made. But much more important than the analytical representation is the target of these activities. In fact, with difference to, for instance, sales and operation planning, in which you are also considering qualitative issues and targets such as service level and company addressable market, and with difference to production and materials planning and production scheduling, in which you are considering also synchronization issues and order respects and delivery, in the master production scheduling you are basically follow an economic target and therefore a profit optimization in terms of objective function. Or dually, if you do not want to pursue a profit optimization, you can use a cost minimization objective function, which in this case implies that you also have to consider opportunity costs, such as lost sales costs. In order to illustrate this activity, and in order to illustrate the relevance of pursuit currently demand, let me use an example. For instance, let's consider the cumulative demand of the company, which can be made of, for instance, orders already confirmed and available within the frozen period, as well as demand forecast, which is available throughout the planning horizon. In this graph here, we have the cumulative demand, which is showing an increase throughout time. One first production strategy available is that it is called a chase plan, in which we try to use production resources striving to follow the demand rate, so by increasing, for instance, production rate over time. Another approach could be the one called level plan, in which we try to use production resources in a more regular way so as not to stress production resources and to compensate for increasing demand by using inventories. Of course, any other planning strategy would be inefficient because more stressing toward the resources and less productive in terms of inventories. If we want to compare these two planes, so the level plan and the chase plan, we can consider the most relevant cost in terms of the objective function. Costs which are, of course, the stock holding cost and the production cost. Stock holding cost may be including all those cost items connected to the physical handling and storage of items, as well as, for instance, insurance costs. But we should not be forgetting running capital costs or opportunity costs concerned to the financial burden of inventories, as well as obsolescence costs, because anytime you build some inventories, you have the risk to have them unsold at the end of the planning period. As for production costs, we have to consider the setup costs or any extra inefficiency which occurs due to changeover, retuning machines, as so on so far, as well as resource productivity and availability, because the more you stress resources, the less productive they will perform. Not to mention, again, not to forget, again, quality issues. Well, if we compare the chase approach and the level approach with respect to these two cost items, we see that the level approach is much more useful when you want to mitigate production costs, while the chase approach is much more useful when you want to control and reduce stockholding costs. Of course, as for any real planning problem in real life, you also have to consider uncertainty, which may be affecting your own data, as well as input, as well as operating condition. If we consider also uncertainty, for instance, an unexpected surge in demand or a machine breakdown, then the level approach is usually more useful because it does not stress that much production resources trying to follow so close the demand. So the master production schedule is a very complex task intent with multiple trade-offs to be considered within the same objective function, and it has to deal with a multi-product, multi-plan decision-making in an environment which is strongly affected with uncertainty. A traditional approach in which a human planner is performing trial and errors in order to produce this plan is, in nowadays scenario, totally unfeasible, while analytical or algorithmic optimization, which will be discussed in the following modules, are usually very useful to support the production planner. But much more important than the analytical optimization is the availability of tools which may be allowing quick and flexible simulations in terms of what-if scenario or overall scenario analysis, so in this way properly supporting a flexible and quick decision making.